الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله لقد جاءت رسل ربنا بالحق سبحانك يا ربنا لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك نستغفرك ونتوب إليك وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو حي لا يموت بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير وأشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله الغر الميامين وأصحابه نجوم الدين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين أما بعد عباد الله اتقوا الله يقول الله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. We are created in this life. Many of the humankind, they don't know why they are present here. We as Muslims, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the perfect and definite answer to it. He said subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ يُطَعِمُونَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. That means we are not here, we are not present here for any purpose except to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this should be the main purpose, should be the main target for all of us, you know, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it has been narrated, you know, by many of the companions and the successors, the interpretation of worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is, I look at it as two components, you know, in our life. We should have in the inner of us, you know, the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we should have in the outer of us the practice of getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the main purpose, you know, behind it, you know. Now, I'm sorry to tell you, many Muslims, they became materialistic, you know. They are interested in different matters, you know. They compete with each other for any other matters, you know, besides this, you know. They don't care about this, you know, Ilah. To the extent that I have heard a commentary, a comment that you're Muslim, you know, what they have done, you know, to the humanity, you know. You did not help them, you know, in medicine. You did not help them in economy. You did not help, you know, in politics. And you name it, you know. If this is our standard, you know, I'm sorry, I feel shame, you know, about it, you know. Even the Prophet, what did he do? He did not find, you know, he did not uncover any medication, you know, to the humanity. But he is the greatest, you know, among us. Why? Because in the hereafter, he is going to bring with him the largest number to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's what he said, you know. فأرجو أن أكون what was he given صلى الله عليه وسلم ما من نبي إلا وقد أوتي من الآيات ما آمن عليه البشر وكان ما أوتيته وحيا فأرجو أن أكون أكثرهم تابعا يوم القيامة. None of the prophets or messenger was sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without an evidence, without a miracle, you know. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala supported him by it, you know. The miracle I was given, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, was the revelation, this Holy Quran. And I hope that I'm going to have the largest number of followers, you know, in the hereafter. And you recited in the Qur'an. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appreciated what had done by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam do? He cleaned the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of the gods. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّا فَتَحْنَا لَكَ فَتْحًا مُبِينًا لِيَغْفِرَ لَكَ اللَّهُ. Okay, I agree with you that we cannot relate these actions from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the ordinary response that we have in this life. But here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala connected it to it. He said subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّا فَتَحْنَا لَكَ فَتْحًا مُبِينًا لِيَغْفِرَ لَكَ اللَّهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَتْأَخَرَ وَيُتِمَّ نِعْمَتَهُ عَلِيكَ وَيَهْدِيَكَ لَكَ صِرَاطًا مُسْتَقِيمًا وَيَنْصُرَكَ اللَّهُ نَصْرًا عَزِيزًا. All of these great matters, some of them never happened to any humankind except for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as mentioned in the hadith al-Shafa'ah, and that the intercession that none of the highly respected, you know, prophets was given any statement similar to لِيَغْفِرَ لَكَ اللَّهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَتَأْخِرَ. And here in this verse, I look at it, you know, that it's connected completely when the Prophet ﷺ cleaned the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From what did he clean it? Not from the dirt, you know. Now, I'm sorry to tell you, even some Muslims, you know, they appreciate the one who cleans some dirt, you know, on the floor, or who feeds someone, or this or not. But they don't care a lot, you know, about the one who cleaned the heart from anyone except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one who cleaned the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of those dirty matters. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even when he conquered Mecca, you will not enter the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala till all of those fake gods, they are taken away, you know, outside. He will not even enter the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when he entered the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after this spiritual cleaning, you know, of it, what did he do? He did not just show himself, he's a great man, you know. He did not only show himself, you know, as a great person, you know, conquered Mecca. The first action he did, what was it? To pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We as Muslims, this is what we need in our life. We need to find our way. We need to find our relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In one hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that these are three items. Whoever practices them is going to taste the sweetness of his belief. I'm sorry to tell you, many believers, you know, they don't taste the sweetness of their belief. Firstly, to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger much more than anyone else. I'm sorry to tell you, when I was young, you know, they told us, be careful. Don't love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam a lot, otherwise you are going to be worshiper of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is completely against what has been mentioned in this particular hadith. Nowadays, we hear some opposite comment, you know, of it, which is completely wrong also. It's not necessary to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your messenger. Only be in good character, you know. Present to the humanity, you know, penicillin or insulin or aircraft or this or that. And that's it, you know. You don't have to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't have to love his messenger, you know. This is the whole story behind it, you know. And both of them, they are completely wrong. When I practice my love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when I practice my love to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, here, as a Muslim, I started to build some relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I start to figure out some spiritual component there, okay? You and me as a humankind, we are of two components. We have this body, and we are obliged to take care of it. And we are also a soul. We have a soul. We have non-physical component, you know, of us. And we tend to forget this, you know, and just throw it away. We don't care about it, you know. The one who presented us, you know, with penicillin, he may, according to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he may prolong the life of some people, you know, for 1 hour, or 1 day, or 1 year, or 10 years, then what's going to happen? If I die right now, what's going to happen? You are going to take my watch, you are going to take my eyeglasses, you know, you'll ship me, you know, back, you know, and they'll take my clothes, you know, and nothing of these physical assets that we are spending all of our life, you know, to it, nothing of them, they are going to go with me, you know, on the ground. I'm going to be left alone there. But don't imagine that everyone is like me. No, you have people, they build their relation there. They love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They build their relation, you know, with the Holy Quran. They build their relation, you know, with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And these people, you know, they are going to be quite rich, you know, in this position when they are left under the ground, you know. They are going to be, yani here, my teacher who taught me Qur'an, you know, really I appreciate him a lot, you know. He did not give me anything for this life. He did not give me money, but he gave me something that I was about to tell you that it's helpful for the hereafter. I'm completely wrong. No, it's helpful for this life and the hereafter. It's going to make me, you know, well familiar with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants me to do. Now I see these faces, you know, nowadays. Why did you come now? You came here because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants all of you, you know, to join, listen to the khutbah and pray to rak'ahs. Okay? How great is this, you know, when a humankind who is interested, you know, in eating, drinking, and sleeping, you know, he knows what Allah wants from him. What should be done right now, okay? This is when you look at it, you know, even though it may sound for some of us, you know, very simple, you know, and this is our habit, you know, and nothing great there, you know, but this is the greatest thing ever you have in your life, you know, when you are according to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I don't know about your people, you know, I know about myself, you know. When I am, you know, according to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I'm going to be in the best position. Sometimes I wish that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take my soul away, you know, because I am in the position that Allah wants from me. But I'm telling you, not every all positions that and circumstances that I get myself exposed to, they are the same, especially when I sleep or go to bathroom or do this or that, you know. But I hate myself, you know, sometimes, you know. Some position I hate to face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in such a setting, you know, that given to me, you know, by myself, you know, by my interest, you know, by being, you know, aiming, you know, and concentrating in certain issues, you know, which is not going to make any difference, you know. The, one of the greatest women, you know, in the old days, you know, she had a dress. And just imagine, you know, when you say in old days, you know, what's about these dresses, you know? They are not sophisticated like our dresses, you know, that we have nowadays, for sure. And she got a little bit, you know, proud of herself and said, Abu Bakr Siddiq, he said, listen, now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't look at you. I should ask myself, how many days, how many years I spend in this life and Allah doesn't look at me? The second question, what value I have in this life, you know, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't look at me? Am I an animal? Yes, I became like an animal, you know. I eat, I drink, I sleep, okay, I have relation, you know. I'm not here to argue, you know, the humankind, they have more sophisticated way, you know, of achieving those matters, you know. But if the target and the aim is the same, we are similar to animals. But when I build my relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, here I confirmed my humanity, that I'm a humankind. I am not an animal, you know. I have something else, you know, something extra. And that's why in that particular hadith about the sweet of belief, it was followed by another item, which we failed to do it in many occasions, you know. The Prophet said about the second item, وَأَنْ يُحِبَّ الرَّجُلَ لَا يُحِبُّهُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ. To love your parents, you know, all humankind, they share the matter of loving their parents, you know. But great person, you know, like Abu Bakr Siddiq, he loves his parents through the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why he said, Sayyidina Abu Bakr didn't say so. He said, Ya Rasulullah, when his father became Muslim, you know, Ya Rasulullah, if your uncle Abu Talib became Muslim, it's going to be much more happy event event, you know, of my father to become Muslim. Who is not delighted, you know, when he has his father becoming Muslim and saved from hellfire, all of us. But here Abu Bakr al-Siddiq was not that happy, you know. You will be much more happier, you know, when if the Abu Talib became Muslim. Why? Why? Because he knows that the Prophet loved this much more, you know. And he, all of his relation, all of his love to everyone, and يُحِبَّ الرَّجُلَ لَا يُحِبُّ اللَّهِ, all of these matters, you know, which we practice out of our nature, you know. Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq did not practice it out of nature. He practiced it through Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why in one of those fights, you know, Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq was about to get out, you know, and fight against his son. One of the dearest and most beloved one to him, he wants to fight against him, you know, and the Prophet said, but ta'ala bi nafsika ya Abu Bakr. Okay, stay, we would like you to stay with us. You see, those matters, you know, and you hate brothers, we should at least experience it once in our life, you know, to build our relation according to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? All of our relation built on benefit I get from you. Even this talk, you know, be sure, after this talk, I'm going to listen to people, you know, was I good, you know, or not good, you know. And be sure that this is not for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's sake. This is just to prove myself. And most of my practice, you know, in this life, to show that I'm good man, you know, which is completely wrong. I hope that I have one of those matters, you know. One for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's sake. Not for myself. I'm not a servant, you know, of myself. I'm not high up by myself. I was created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm going to live according to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I should have, and this is perhaps the simplest way, you know, and the easiest way, okay? I should have all of my life, you know, submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you feel that I'm exaggerating, you know, the greatest creation among us is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What description he was given? By who? By his wife. When I say his wife, a person, you know, who sat next to him, you know, many years, she said, Sayyida Aisha radiallahu anha, وَمَنْ تَقَمَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ سَلِمْ لِنَفْسِهِ قَالَتْ إِلَّا أَنْ تُنْتَهَكَ حُرُمَاتُ اللَّهِ فَيَنْتَقِمَ اللَّهِ. What does this mean, you know, this such noble, you know, personality, you know, of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, never ever take revenge for himself, you know, unless there is something related to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he's going to be really angry, you know, and he's going to take revenge, not for himself, you know, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as I said, you know, before, when he conquered Mecca, you know, what was the main concern of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? The main concern of the Prophet was that he did not want the people of Mecca to know about his army, because he did not want to have a bloodshed. He did not want to have a lot of casualties, you know, of the Meccan people. Anyone who is going to be there, you know, beside the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is going to have massive killing, you know, just to take revenge of those people, you know, who called him fake, called him black magician, called him crazy, kick him out, you know, of his country, you know. All of these matters, all of these actions, they were done badly, you know, to him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And his main concern was, he did not like to kill these people, you know. And that's why he made it in a very smart way, and made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabbi, khuz al-uyun wal-akhbar an ahli Makkah hatta nufajir. Why? Because he wants to have the lowest number of casualties, you know, when he wants to clean the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see how noble is his aim, how noble is his target, how noble is his look, you know, and we are entitled to follow him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What was the third one, you know, in that particular hadith? To taste the sweet of Islam or Iman or Deen. وَأَنْ يَكْرَهَ أَنْ يَعُودَ فِي الْكُفْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ نَجَّاهُ اللَّهُ مِنْ كَمَا يَكْرَهُ أَنْ يُلْقَى فِي النَّارِ. Okay, firstly, how you are going to achieve this third condition, firstly, you should have full recognition between the believers and non-believers. Then, you should hate yourself, you know, to go back to disbelief. I heard this, you know, from a person, you know, American person who converted. He said, congratulate me today. Why? He said, I'm today 34 years old, you know. I became Muslim on 17. Alhamdulillah, today I have equation, you know, between the kufr and iman in my age. You see how noble is this look, you know? He looked at his time, you know, as wasted, you know, or did not count it from his life, you know, the 17 years that he lived, you know. And this is for me. At least for me, you know, is going to explain what's the meaning of وَأَنْ يَكْرَهَ أَنْ يَعُودَ فِي الْكُفْرِ بَعْدَ كَمَا يَكْرَهُ أَنْ يُلْقَى فِي النَّارِ. Okay? Because for such a person, you know, he forgot his identity, he forgot his age, he forgot everything, you know, and the main concern was for him that I'm living now the equal age, you know, building my relation with Allah subhanahu. Have something to do with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to make the long story short for everyone, it's very great to be Muslim, you know, but much greater than it, you know, to try to build your relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the hereafter. You see the difference between us, you know, in this life? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the hereafter, وَلَلْآخِرَةُ أَكْبَرُ دَرَجَاتٍ وَأَكْبَرُ تَفْضِيلًا. You are going to have the massive difference, the tremendous difference, you know, between the ranks, you know, and the people, you know, the brothers, you know, the neighbors, and you name it, you know, you are going to find it much, much, much more pronounced, you know, in the hereafter, you know. And we should ask myself, what position I'm going to be at, okay? For sure, I'm not a prophet, okay? And that's mean that the highest rank, you know, of the humanity, I'm not going to achieve, you know. I'm not a companion, okay? But at least, you know, in my life here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave me this great favor from him, the Holy Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave me this great religion called Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave me this great man called Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. At least I should appreciate what I have been given from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot. I should live in this life, you know, according to this, you know. And everything, you know, I'm not telling you to starve, you know, or not eating, or no, everything is going to come secondary, you know, to this, you know. Your prophet, you know, your beloved person, you know, he never filled his belly, you know, for two consecutive days, as mentioned, you know. Sometimes, as mentioned, Shama'il al-Tirmidhi, he will not find the worst type, you know, of date to fill his stomach with. And this is not because it's not available, you know. From that first day he hit Medina al-Munawwara, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he has with him, joining him, Jafna to Sa'd ibn Ubadah. Large dish, you know, that it may contain a camel, you know. Every day come to the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and sometimes, or many times, or most of the times, the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is going to take this, you know, and deliver to someone else, you know, to feed someone else, you know, and he will keep himself, you know, and his family, you know, hungry. And that's what Imam Busiri said, وَشَدَّ مِنْ سَغَبٍ أَحْشَاءَهُ وَطَوَى تَحْتَ الْحِجَارَةِ كَشْحًا مُتْرَفَ الْأَذَانِ أَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ.
Thank you very much, Shaykh.
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. والعاقبة للمتقين. Okay, I keep saying والعاقبة للمتقين. What's the meaning of والعاقبة للمتقين? The end of our play, you know, or role or whatever is going to lead to the متقين. And you should look after yourself and the surrounding, you know, who are متقين, you know. And this is going to be, and this is what makes me happy, you know, because when you look at the Prophet ﷺ, only on the standard of the dunya, he was not the greatest one, you know, but he is the greatest one, you know, because al-aqibatu lil-muttaqin, and he's going to be shown. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا وحبيبنا وقرة أعيننا محمد خير نبي اصطفاه ورحمة للعالمين أرسله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين عباد الله اتقوا الله يقول الله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون عباد الله إن الله أمركم بأمر عظيم بدأ فيه بنفسه فقال سبحانه وتعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وارض اللهم عن ساداتنا ومولينا الكرام أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر العشرة وعن عمي حبيبك وسبطيه وعن أزواج النبي وعن المهاجرين والأنصار وعن أهل بدر وأحد والحديبية وعن سائر أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وتابعيه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم أصلح أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم فرج الكرب عن أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم اجمع على الهدى أمر أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم اغفر لأمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم ارحم أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم رحمة عامة اللهم أعز أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم انصر أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم اجبر أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم أغث أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم يا من لطفت في خلق السماوات والأرض ولطفت بالأجنة في بطون أمهاتها ارضف بنا وبسائر المسلمين في قضائك وقدرك لطفا يليق بكرمك يا أرحم الراحمين ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون